In this video, we're going to finish out the Solving Multi-Step Equations worksheet under the Infinite Algebra 2 tab on the CUDA software website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet, and it's the first worksheet within the Equations and Inequalities section. So remember, our goal in solving an equation is to isolate the variable in order to figure out what the variable is equivalent to. In this case, our variable is p. So I'm going to start by distributing negative 2, and I'm going to distribute a negative 3. As opposed to subtracting this 3, I'm going to add the negative 3 and then distribute that negative 3. There's addition in between these two terms, subtraction in between these two terms, and at the same time, I'm going to combine my like terms on my left-hand side. So I'm going to combine 10p with p, and I'm going to combine 9 and 11. 10p minus p is going to be equal to 9p. 9 minus 11 equals a negative 2. So I'm going to be adding negative 2, and that's going to be equal to negative 2 times 2p is negative 4p, plus negative 2 times 4 is negative 8, plus negative 3 times 2p is negative 6p, minus negative 3 times 2, which is a negative 6. However, remember, subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive. So as opposed to subtracting negative 6, I'll add a positive 6. Now I'm going to combine like terms on my right-hand side. I'm going to combine negative 4p and negative 6p together, and I'm going to combine negative 8 and 6 together. So I have 9p plus negative 2, and that's going to be equal to negative 4p plus negative 6p, which is negative 10p, plus negative 8 plus a positive 6 will give me a negative 2. My next step, I'm going to add 10p to both sides. And doing this, negative 10p plus 10p equals 0. So I'll have negative 2 on my right-hand side left over, and that's going to be equal to 9p plus 10p, which is 19p. And I'm still adding that negative 2. So my next step, I'm going to add a positive 2 to both sides. Continuing my work over here, 19p plus negative 2 plus 2 will be 19p, since negative 2 plus 2 is 0, and that's going to be equal to negative 2 plus 2, which is 0. So I have that 19p is equal to 0. When I divide both sides by 19, 0 divided by any number is 0. So 0 divided by 19 is 0, so p is equal to 0 in number 15. That means if I take that value of 0 and plug it in for p, this side of the equation will equal the right side. So you can see 10 times 0 is 0. So I'll be left with 9 minus 11, which is negative 2. Negative 2 times 0. So I'll just have negative 2 times 4, which is negative 8. This term is 0. Negative 3 times a negative 2 is positive 6. Negative 2 is indeed equal to negative 8 plus 6, because negative 8 plus 6 is a negative 2. So I know that was a little messy, but we checked our work, and 0 is indeed the value of p. Moving on to number 16, I'm going to start by distributing the 3 on the left and the negative 6 on the right. Negative 10n plus 3 times 8 is positive 24, plus 3 times 8n is a positive 24n. That's equal to negative 6 times n, which is negative 6n, minus negative 6 times 4, which is negative 24. However, when I'm subtracting a negative 24, it's the same as adding a positive 24. So now I'm going to combine my like terms on my left-hand side. I'll combine negative 10n and 24n. Negative 10n plus 24n will be 14n, and I'm adding that to 24, and that is all equal to negative 6n plus 24. Next, I'm going to add 6n to both sides. 14n plus 6n is a positive 20n, so I have 20n plus 24, and that's going to be equal to negative 6n plus 6n, which is 0, plus 24, which gives me 24. Next, I'll subtract 24 from both sides in order to isolate the term that contains our variable in this case, the 20 in. 24 minus 24 is 0, so I'll have 20 in on my left, and 24 minus 24 is 0. So rewriting this over here, I have 20 in equal to 0. So when I divide both sides by 20, I get that n is equal to 0, because 0 divided by any number is 0. So my solution in number 16 is 0. In number 17, I'm going to start by adding the opposite, so adding negative 1 times negative 9x minus 4 as opposed to subtracting 1 times negative 9x minus 4. So then I can distribute this 10 with addition in between, and I can distribute this negative 1 with subtraction in between. And while I'm at it, I'll combine my like terms on the right hand side, which is the 5 and the 3. 10 times x is 10x, plus 10 times 3 is 30, plus negative 1 times negative 9x is a positive 9x, and then we're subtracting, so minus negative 1 times 4, which is negative 4. But as always, subtracting a negative is the same as adding the positive. So as opposed to subtracting negative 4, we'll add a positive 4. And that's going to be equal to x minus 5 plus 3. So negative 5 plus 3 will be a negative 2. Now I'm going to combine my like terms on the left. I'll combine 30 and 4 together, and I'll also combine 10x and 9x. 10x plus 9x is 19x. 30 plus 4 is 34, and that is all equal to x plus negative 2. My next step, I'm going to subtract x from both sides. 19x minus x is a positive 18x, and then we're adding 34, and that's equal to x minus x, which is 0, plus negative 2, so we have negative 2 left on the right-hand side. My next step, I'm going to subtract 34 from both sides. My 34s will cancel out, so I'll have that 18x is equal to negative 2 minus 34, which is negative 36. And I know that when I divide both sides by 18, that x is going to be equal to negative 36 divided by 18, which is a negative 2. So negative 2 is my solution in number 17. Now in number 18, you can see that on the left-hand side, I will have to distribute 12. And I will also have to distribute 12 on the right-hand side. So since 12 is multiplied to some quantity on both sides, I'm going to start by dividing both sides by 12. Whatever I do to the left, I do to the right, and vice versa. So you can see that my 12s will actually cancel out, since 12 divided by 12 is 1. So I'll be left on my left-hand side with 2k plus 11, and that's going to be equal to 2k plus 12. Now I'm going to subtract 2k from both sides. In doing this, 2k minus 2k is 0, so I'll have 11 on my left-hand side, and that's equal to 2k minus 2k, which is 0, plus 12, so 12 on my right-hand side. However, we know that 11 does not equal 12, therefore in number 18, there is no solution. That means that there is no value that we can plug into k to make the left side of our equation equal the right side of our equation. Moving on to number 19, I'll start by distributing negative 12, and I'll also distribute negative 9. There's subtraction in between these two terms and addition in between those. Negative 12 times x is negative 12x, and we're subtracting negative 12 times 12, which is negative 144. However, if we're subtracting a negative, it's the same as adding a positive. So as opposed to subtracting negative 144, we're going to add positive 144. Now, on my right-hand side of my equation, I have negative 9 times 1, which is negative 9, plus negative 9 times 7x, which is negative 63x. I'll add 63x to both sides. So negative 63x plus 63x is 0. Negative 12x plus 63x equals 51x. And we're adding that to 144, which equals negative 9. Now I'm going to subtract 144 from both sides. to get that 51x equals negative 9 minus 144, which is negative 153. When I divide both sides by 51, I'll get that x is equal to negative 153 divided by 51, which is a negative 3. So negative 3 is my solution in number 19. That means I can plug negative 3 in for x, and the left side will indeed equal the right side. Now, the last problem in this set of directions, number 20. I'll start by distributing 10, and I'll change this to adding a negative 5 so that I can distribute the negative 5. I'll have negative 11 plus 10 times p, which is 10p, plus 10 times 10, which is 100, and that's equal to 4, plus negative 5 times 2p is negative 10p, plus negative 5 times 11 is negative 55. Now I'll combine my like terms. I can combine negative 11 with 100 on my left-hand side, and I can combine 4 with negative 55 on my right. It's going to be a positive 89, and we're adding that to 10p, and that's going to be equal to 4 plus negative 55, which is negative 51, and that will be added to a negative 10p. Next, I'll add 10p to both sides. So essentially, I'm moving my term with my p to the left. So I'll have 89 plus 20p, and that is equal to negative 51. Then I'll subtract 89 from both sides to get that 20p is equal to negative 51 minus 89, which is negative 140. When I divide both sides by 20, we'll get that p is equal to negative 140 divided by 20, which is a negative 7. So negative 7 is our answer in number 20. Lastly on this worksheet, our critical thinking question. Number 21, explain two ways you could solve 20 equals 5 times negative 3 plus x. I know that 5 can go into 20 evenly, so one way I can start this is to divide both sides by 5. Since 5 is multiplied to everything on the right, when I divide by 5, my 5s will cancel out, and 20 divided by 5 would be 4. So I'd have 4 equal to negative 3 plus x. Then if I was to add 3 to both sides, I'd get that 7 is equal to x. So one way I can solve is to start by dividing by 5 first. So I can divide by 5 at the start. So that's one way. My second way, I can distribute that 5. If I distribute the 5, I'll have 20 equal to 5 times negative 3, which is negative 15, plus 5 times x, which is 5x. So when I add 15 to both sides, I'll get that 35 is equal to 5x, and dividing by 5, I'll get that 7 is equal to x. So you can see I get the same solution. So another way to solve for this equation is to distribute the 5 at the start. So you can see that there are multiple ways to approach solving a multi-step equation problem. And as I work through these problems with you, because I solved one way, doesn't mean there's not another way to solve the problem. So feel free to try different ways on your own. Comment below if you approached any of the previous problems starting a different way than I did. Also, go ahead and comment if you have any questions. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. And with that, we finished the Solving Multi-Step Equations worksheet under the Algebra 2 section.